Have you ever wondered what it takes to construct an engine that dwarfs even the largest trucks on the road today? You might think you've seen it all, but trust us, this mechanical marvel, Fiat S76, is bigger and bolder than anything you could have ever imagined. But just how enormous is it? What makes this powerhouse of pistons and gears so extraordinary? And how does it fit into the annals of automotive history? Stay tuned as we take you on an epic journey into the past, present, and future of the Fiat S76. The world's largest car engine that's truly bigger than anything you've seen before. In 1910, the Italian automaker Fiat had a singular mission: to dethrone the reigning land speed record holder, the Blitzen Benz. And so, the Fiat S76 was born, a beastly creation designed for one purpose and one purpose only: to dominate the racetrack. The heart of the Fiat S76 is a monstrous 28.5-liter inline-four engine. That's right, you heard it correctly, 28.5 liters. This engine isn't just an engine, it's a force of nature, capable of churning out a mind-blowing 300 horsepower. Now, you might not be overly impressed by the 300 horsepower output, considering the engine's substantial size, but it boasts more torque than a Bugatti Veyron. And remember, we're talking about a car from 1910, but it's not just about the power, it's about what this beast can do with it. In 1911, the Fiat S76 hit the racetrack with one goal in mind: to claim the 1 mile land speed record. And guess what? It succeeded. It reached a jaw-dropping speed of 116 miles per hour, setting a record that would be talked about for generations to come. But in 1912, when they attempted an even faster run, disaster struck. The car couldn't make the required return run, and the record was disqualified. Was it a case of mechanical misfortune or a strategic mishap? We'll let you be the judge. Now let's talk about the elephant in the room, or should we say, the engine in the car. The Fiat S76's massive engine demands attention. It necessitates a cowl that stands comically high, resulting in proportions that are nothing short of bizarre. Imagine a road-going GB Model R with an attitude problem, and you're getting close. If the sheer size and power weren't enough, the Fiat S76 had another trick up its exhaust pipe. It spits hellfire and sounds meaner than anything you've ever heard, even scarier than an army of 10,000 Carlo Abarths could ever come up with. So, even if you're not into old car history, you can't help but be amazed by this roaring beast of a car. The S76 is powered by a four-cylinder engine that's truly massive, with a size of 28,353 cubic centimeter. Just to give you an idea, it's like having an engine block that's 7.48 inches wide and 9.84 inches tall. This beast of an engine generates a whopping 290 metric horsepower, equivalent to 210 kilowatts when it hits 1400 revolutions per minute, RPM. It's equipped with four valves, and it kicks things off with a trembler coil. Each cylinder has not one, but two spark plugs. To light things up, it relies on a high-voltage magneto of the Bosch type DR44. And to keep it cool, it's water-cooled. It also featured a transmission with a chain drive, a sturdy axle suspension equipped with front and rear leaf springs along with rear longitudinal struts, and a four-speed gearbox that also included a reverse gear. Interestingly, the radiator design used in this pioneering prototype for record-breaking purposes was later adopted by Fiat for their future road models. After they built two car engines between 1910 and 1911, Fiat decided to make a similar engine for an airship. They made a few changes, reducing the number of valves to three, two exhaust valves, and one intake valve, and increasing the spark plugs to three. This airship engine was created from 1912 to 1913 and was used on Forlanini airships. Fast forward to November 2014, and something incredible happened. A team led by Duncan Pittaway, along with Leonardo E.M. Sordi, an expert in mechanics and magnetos, managed to get the S76 engine working again. They rebuilt the entire ignition system, including the spark plugs, put in a full set of engine bearings with shells and white metal, and even reworked the original crankcase number 2 to make sure everything was aligned properly. This was a significant task considering the engine's age of over 100 years. While more work was still needed before the car was fully operational, they managed to complete it in 2015. The Beast of Turin made its grand return, roaring to life and being showcased and driven for the first time in nearly a century at the Goodwood Festival of Speed, from June 23rd to 26, 2015. It was a remarkable feat of engineering restoration and a true marvel of automotive history.